To have a trial directly after being captured is almost unheard of, especially with the backlog that we are having in our court system today. Jesus of Nazareth is most certainly being treated as a serious threat to our national security.
Oh yes, I have just received a report during our break saying that well-known zealot Barabbas has been released by Governor Pilate at the request of the crowd who has been standing at the palace steps. Evidently, there has been a large negative reaction of Jesus' entry to Jerusalem, and a number of citizens are demanding that Jesus be executed for not only his religious teachings, but for his consistently breaking of the Sabbath law.
Yes, Gloria. You know, it is a well-known fact that many of Jesus' miracles seem to have happened on the Sabbath. The last straw seemed to have been when Jesus raised that guy Lazarus from the dead. Apparently, the Pharisees have had it just up to here with Jesus breaking Sabbath laws, and that at that point, they did put out a reward for his capture. Do you have any idea, Lori, on how Jesus was found? I mean, beyond the fact that he was quite visible when he entered into the city of Jerusalem.
Well, again, Stephen, the reports are a little sketchy. But according to one of my sources on the Council of Pharisees, it was one of Jesus' own disciples who turned him in.
No way.
Yes, way. A man by the name of Judas Iscariot seems to have signed the claim voucher for 30 pieces of silver.
Wow.
And led authorities to a small garden just outside of Jerusalem. Seems he identified Jesus by giving him a kiss on the cheek.
Well, some kind of friend he turned out to be. It really does appear to me, Lori, that Jesus obviously is not a very good judge of character. I mean, he seems to not pick out his friends very well, or even his disciples. And you know, from what I understand, quite frankly, Lori, he'll just befriend anybody who meets him.
I know what you mean, Stephen.
Hang on, this is unbelievable.
Hey, I was just talking with one of my friends the other day about how Jesus was inviting tax collectors to dinner parties.
No, Lori, that's not what I mean. We're getting another report indicating that Jesus has been sentenced to death. To die on a hill on a cross outside of the city. The hill is called Golgotha. You might be familiar with that hill. We had a lot of executions up there in the last year or two. I just can't believe that this man, who has preached nothing but love and forgiveness, is being murdered. And at the request of our religious leaders. You know, there must be something more about this man than what's meeting the eye.
I would think so. Stephen, I was just told that we were able to get a short interview with the guy who turned Jesus in to the authorities. Seems that Judas is wanting to make a confession about his actions. If you will, please roll the tape.
We'll try.
Audio.
I help you, it matters that you see. These sort of kind of things are coming hard to me. It's taken me some time to work out what to do. I weighed the whole thing up before I came to you. I had no thought at all about my own reward. I really didn't come here on my own accord. Just don't say I'm down for all time. I came because I had to, I'm the one who saw Jesus got control it like he did before. And furthermore, I know that Jesus thinks so too. Jesus wouldn't mind that I was here with you. I had no thought at all about my own reward. I really didn't come here on my own accord. Just don't say I
thank you.
Why are we the prophets? Why am I the one who sees the sad solution, knows what must be done? I have no thought at all about my own reward. I really didn't come here on my own accord. Just don't say I'm dead for the whole time.
After protesting, forget the excuses. We want information. Get out of the law.
We have the papers. We need to arrest him. You know his movements, we know the law.
Your help in this matter will go unrewarded.
We'll pay you in silver, cash on the nails. We just need to know where the soldiers can find him.
With no crowd around him,
then we can bail.
I don't need your blood money.
Oh, that doesn't matter, our expenses are good.
Your blood money.
But you might as well take it. We think that you should.
Think of the thing you can do with that money. Choose any charity. Give to the poor. We've noted your motives. We've noted your feelings. This isn't blood money. It's a fee-nothing.
Obviously, Lori, the film has been tampered with to where the Pharisees aren't wanting to be seen on film on this confession that's
going
on. Yeah. Well, while our camera crew is driving out on the scene of Golgotha, it seems that we have received a phone call from a man named Matthew who has been giving us a description of what has been going on out at Golgotha. You know, and if you'd like, I can read a bit of the transcript of his report.
Okay, thanks. That would be great.
Well, he says that from noon until 3, the whole earth darkened like a total eclipse of the sun. Some guys who were standing by heard Jesus say, my God, why have you abandoned me? And one witness was suggesting that he was calling out to Eli. You know, that could be possible, I guess. That makes sense to me. And one of them ran up with a sponge soaked with sour wine and lifted it up on a stick to give him a drink, while others joked, saying, don't be in such a hurry. Let's see if Elijah does actually come and rescue him. But then Jesus cried out again and breathed his last. And at that moment, the temple curtain was ripped in two from the top down to the bottom. An earthquake was reported, and there were some rocks being split into pieces. And what's more, the tombs that had been opened up, and many of the bodies in those tombs of believers of Jesus, who have been asleep in their graves, were raised. The captain of the guard and those around him were filled with terror when the earth quaked and that they saw all of these dead people walking around. My word. Well, Lori, time is running out on today's program, but I'm asking you and our viewing audience to stay tuned to this station as we continue to cover today's most miraculous events, the capture and crucifixion of what is certainly going to turn out to be one of Israel's most important prophets, Jesus the Nazarene.
Even the Romans are calling this man the Son of God. Stephen, what have we done in killing this man if he truly is the Son of God?
I don't know, Lori, on how to give you an answer on that one. We'll just have to keep watching this story as it continues to develop. Well, thank you folks for being with us today and watching us on the news. This is Steve Jacobs.
And this is Lori Isaac saying shalom for now. Please join us next week on
Jerusalem Today. And as As we are closing our program, let us once more hear a number by the United Congregational Choir as they bless us with a song by the title, Were You There When They Crucified My Lord, in honor of this fallen man, Jesus.